For those of you who don't know me, my name is Rich Kazurian, and I am the chairman of the board of the stage left. And on behalf of the board, I want to welcome you here this evening. This is our first Roasty Toasty. Hopefully, it will be an annual event where we will recognize people who have contributed to Interstage Life over the years. And it certainly fits the gentleman we are honoring this evening. Wherever he is. I also want to mention that in addition to this being a fundraiser, and a Roasty Toasty, it's also a time to have fun. And I wore my have fun socks, so when I have these on, you know that it's time to have fun. It's party time. So we want you all to enjoy yourselves this evening. And this is a little bit like a celebration. When they have a wedding, where they go and they clean the glasses. After all the grief you've given me in the last 2 days, you're not ready.
Beth and Denise!
So, this evening, put your hand up when we're ready.
Wait, we're not ready.
You know, the best laid plans are mice and men. You think this was our first show?
Oh my God. Okay.
Are we ready?
Yes.
So, when you hear this sound, everybody laugh, please. We're going to hear it numerous times tonight. So, can we all do it one more time?
Family. Steve, Gloria, Mary, Shirley, and Michael, ready for action. And the Sullivan family. Jeff, Mary, and Steve, on your mark. Let's start the Family Feud.
We got you here now. Got Tom off stage. Cannot hear us. We wish you luck. And the first family we ever flew in wants to book us for $5,000. Give you 15 seconds, please. Maybe something that's off an X-ray.
Your chest.
A kind of plug.
A spark plug.
Somewhere where you go to be alone.
Your room.
A kind of chip.
Potato chip.
Something with a knot in it.
Tie.
Turn around. Okay, here we go. We're going to have more fun. Chef, ready, chef? Yes, excellent. Well, doesn't electricity really come a long way?
Sure.
Survey, chef? Somewhere you go to be alone. I'll go with you. You said, the room. Survey said, kind of neat if you could leave Tom in there and never you'd have to bring him out. Kind of chip by, you said, potato chip. You're 61 points away. Survey said, something with a knot in it, you said. Tie. You need 12 points for $5,000. And we'll never see Tommy again. Survey said.
Thank you.
to our first annual Roasty Toasty dinner show. Now, some of you may know Nancy Murphy. Some of you might be acquainted with her. She's sitting right here. Nancy speaks most eloquently about her experience in interstage left theater being a marker in her life that separates her life into two very distinct portions, her life before ESL and her life after ESL. Now, for Kelly, Don, Mary, and I, we think of Steve Sullivan and ESL as similar vein. ESL before Steve Sullivan, and ESL after Steve Sullivan. Tonight we come to honor and to celebrate a man of immense talent. Someone who has given himself freely and selflessly to this company, his art, and his community at large. Ladies and gentlemen, our good friend, Mr. Phil Dougherty. What's up, Phil?
Hopkinton. So Nancy, you're telling me that you didn't know that that when you were cast as Hetty opposite Steve, you were, had no awareness of his previous entanglements.
I didn't know about Laura and whatever, Karen, is that her name? How was I supposed to know? It was my second show with ESL, right?
Right. It was new to you and ESL, and we're new to ESL. Okay, yeah. But did this happen again in a show called Bye Bye Birdie? You want to talk about that?
Over these entanglements. I've done a lot better now. You know, but there's, I'm not the only one. There's another woman out there who not only has she not felt any guilt, I don't think she's even had a clue.
Thank you.
go a little easier on you, Steve. All right? Yes, I will. Yes, I will. In fact, I might make you cry.
Oh.
What would you rather have? So I've had the pleasure of directing Steve in some 17 to 20 Enterstage Left Theater productions between the years of 2004 and 2017. And I've had the pleasure of actually performing side by side with him and many others. And in his time with us, he's proven himself as a man of great talent, great writer, but of incredible versatility. We often think of Steve as a comedian or a musical comedian, but some of his most striking roles have been in dramas. In 2012, we did One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and Steve came out to audition. And in a moment of inspiration or folly or something, I decided to have him read for the role of Chief. And you know what? Something really intriguing about his reading. So this was in the farmhouse, so I ran upstairs to Kelly in her office and had her come down, because she's my insurance agent in these kinds of decisions. So I had him read the part again, he read the part to Kelly and I, and Kelly was intrigued as well. She said, you know what, let's do it. So he got the role. Now, you might say it's a little counterintuitive casting an older Irish white guy in the role of Chief, right? But if you're going to take a risk on anybody, Steve is always a safe bet. And he did not disappoint. I remember working the last scene of the play in which Chief comes upon McMurphy and realizes that he's been lobotomized. And Steve was having just a little bit of a hard time connecting with the scene or going there. You know, there being that place that actors always strive to go, but sometimes fear. So I took him aside, and I looked at him and I said, Steve, imagine that this is your son, lying there, broken, and he ran the scene again. And he produced one of the most striking, eloquent, heart-wrenching moments we've ever seen on an Enterstage Left Theater production. Over the years, I've gifted a number of roles to Steve. In 2005, as Nancy had mentioned, I wrote a musical extravaganza called Hooray for Hollywood. And Steve was absolutely brilliant as the blustery, womanizing Oscar Meyer, the studio head. And it's a show that I wrote for Steve. So, on opening night, I remember going up to Steve and shaking his hand, and I was just so pleased with how he completely inhabited this character and really made this show work. He was the spine of the show. And I said, Steve, how many people can say that they've had a show written for them? And Steve looked at me with this pride in his eyes that somebody thought enough of his talent, that much of his talent. Then, in 2006, summer of 2006, I handed Steve a script for a little episode of ESL Live that we were doing, and this was a video clip. So we started to tape the video. We had a room full of people. And as we started rolling camera, people started disappearing. I couldn't figure out why. Well, later I found out that people were laughing so hard, they were afraid they were going to spoil the take. So they just left the room. So Steve and I were there, the two of us by ourselves at the end of the taping. This role would become one of his most prolific and enduring.
Hi.
I'm here.
Oh,
what's up?
Are you boxing? For 5DEW, welcome Monofree.
Whatever there,
library novel school, building our homes, or cleaning our streets. They volunteer thousands of hours to help improve the quality of life for our residents. I'm proud of 5DEW, local 103. There's a wave of commitment to our community.
So the zing is when you're sitting in a dark theater and everything just comes together and it just solves and you have that moment, that magical moment, and you feel the tingling in your scalp or whatever it is, and you say, wow, this is something else. So Joe actually found a young actress who worked with Steve in his first production and developed a very close relationship. And she's pictured right there, actually.
name is Farrell. She was 14 in this picture. She's now 34 with a family of her own and lives in Connecticut. And so Joe found a way to reach out to her and to ask her what her experience was like at 14 acting with Steve.
When I first met Steve, I was an eighth grader, auditioning for what I still consider the role of a lifetime. And Steve was ready to be in the first play of his life. My mother had to drag me to the audition, not because I didn't want to be a part of it, but because it felt like the idea of getting to play Anne with an E was too good to be true. I was going through a difficult time in my life, as most teenagers in eighth grade are. Along with the usual friend group drama and a struggle to find where I fit in the world, I had recently lost my grandfather. So, what do a teenage girl with a dramatic emotional life and a kind, quiet older man have in common? This is actually one of the main questions of Anne of Green Gables, a play where Anne finds a kindred spirit in the kind, grandfatherly Matthew Cuthbert. The comparison between talk...
Don't tell me. Can you hear it again?
Barbara?
She was, and she was so happy that we found her and that she was able to. So I can, if we can't figure it out, because I don't want to wait too long. I have the letter. Do you want to bring it up to me, you guys? And I'll read the rest of it. Denise, or somebody get the letter. She's sitting right there next to the computer. In the life of a teenage girl, comfort and ease and kindness are not always easy to come by. They are priceless. They were just what I needed. And doesn't theater often work that way? Somewhere along the line, a show takes on a magical property that is specifically what the audience and the actors need to hear in order to leave the experience changed for the better. Steve is that way too. No one can act alongside him and leave unchanged. I know that ESL refers to the phenomenon of a show that has come alive as the zing. In Anne of Green Gables, Steve's role of Matthew Cuthbert brought zing to the stage, affecting my heart and the hearts of our audience in a way that only Steve can.
So Steve, thanks for the zing. May you continue to zing us for many years to come and feel ours in return.
Thank you, Steve.
So tonight, then, we all come together to celebrate and honor a man of immense talent who has freely given himself to this company, his art, and his community at large.
Sunday.
Yes.
Finally, ladies and gentlemen, our first ESL Roasty Toasty goes to
Steve Sullivan. Us. Appearing on stage with Steve Sullivan.
Steve Sullivan.
Thank you. Lead back to Sean. Okay.
I wasn't even alive, bro. was like a ghost. And then Cuckoo's Nest, I was a murderer. And our town, I get yelled at by a communist. A mice and men, I had a pick on a mentally challenged character. And in 1776, I had a talk like Phil. James Paul, don't you like me? And then, thank God, Paul created the USO show, which is a great, great show. A 15-piece swing band with, set in 1942 over in England with Bob Hope, Bing Crosby, the Andrews Sisters.
Jerry Colonna!
And Jerry Colonna! Well, the last show I had to play Burglar singing Minnie the Moocher as Ebenezer Scrooge. Wait, Paul, you really don't like me, do you? Anyway, I'd like to thank all my fellow ESL cast members. Paul, Kelly, Dawn, Alan, Mary, Keith, Mark, Denise, Nancy, and Phil, and everybody that was in that show. Man, oh man, we had a great time. And got a couple of beers backstage. To that point, Oscar and Woody, what a great show. And then Shakespeare on the Stars. I get cast as Sir Toby Belch, who was a ne'er-do-well drunk and really, really, I had to really think really hard about this role. It stretched my acting chops. Denise Laumeister and all the musical reviews that we did, and Joseph. Well, there was a lot of dance numbers in these things, and they had three rows of dancers, and somehow, I got into the fifth row. Oh, we got trouble. I have been to work with so many great people who are now my lifelong friends, and I consider everybody in this whole room my lifelong friend. Yeah. Thank you. And thank you all for the family. My family, I can't believe it. My son Dennis, son Pete,
Colleen.
Hi, Colleen. Hi, Dennis. We'll be here all night if I go through all 15. And all the cousins and grandchildren and all that stuff. So if you don't mind, I'm going to just skip right on to the star of the show, my wife, Eileen. What a life changer. If you hadn't pushed me into this, I don't know what I would have done. I probably would have killed you by now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Steve. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here tonight.